This story is taken from the Ifa Literary Corpus, and it's the story of Ejiogbe. It's the story of how Ejiogbe became the Oba or monarch of Ifa. There was a time when all the 16 major Odu, also known as Oduodu, they were brothers and they all went around divining, associating amongst themselves without having anyone designated as their Oba or monarch. Ofumeji was the eldest of them, and Ejiogbe was the youngest of them all. And the age difference between Ofumeji and Ejiogbe was so much that Ejiogbe was effectively like their errand boy. So one day they decided to go to Orun, to Olodumare, to ask that Olodumare proclaim one of them the Oba or monarch of the Odu. So they all went to Olodumare's palace, and when Olodumare met with them, Ofumeji, who was the eldest, was the spokesperson. He told Olodumare that, well, we the Odu of Ifa, we divine for trees. Trees selected the Iroko tree as their monarch or Oba. We divine for animals. Animals selected the elephant as their Oba. We divine for birds. Birds selected the ostrich as their monarch. It is time for you, Olodumare, to proclaim one of us, the Oba of all the Ifa. In Orisha culture, no one proclaims himself or herself to be an Oba or a leader, community, or someone who is higher up in authority claims who is going to be an Oba. So Olodumare looked at the 16 Odu and asked them, why do you need to have anyone designated as your Oba? Well, all of them except for Ejiogbe, who was the youngest of them all, said, yes, Olodumare, we want you to make one of us the Oba. It's high time that we, the Odu, have someone who is designated as our Oba. So Olodumare asked them to come back in 16 days' time. And before they left, Olodumare gave them one gift, one mammoth cow. A woolly cow that was so big that they'd never seen anything like this before. And when they got back to Aye, they divided the cow into 15 parts. Ejiogbe was so young compared to all of them, no one even thought of the fact that Ejiogbe need to have a share. So Ejiogbe was the one who carried the share of Ofumeji, the eldest brother, home, went back, took the one for Osemeji, came back again, took the one for all of them one by one. And it was when there were just about 3 portions left to go, now one of them realized that, this young boy that's been so helpful all day, what should we give him? We need to give him something as well. And Ofumeji looked at them and said, well, let's give him the head. Do you want the head of a cow? No, everyone said no. They asked Ejiogbe, say, okay, when you're done, see that head over there, that's the part we left for you. You take that. That's yours. Ejiogbe did not say anything. He took the head of the cow, took it home with him. And Ejiogbe called his diviners to come and divine for him. And when the Babalawo and the Yanifa came and divined for Ejiogbe, they asked Ejiogbe to offer in sacrifice the head of one cow, the big head of a cow. Ijogbe just brought out the part of the cow that no one wanted that they gave to him, and he gave it to the Babalawo. They offered it in sacrifice, and the sacrifice they made with this was they made a type of cow head soup, which the Babalawo and the Yanifa ate. And on the 16th day, they went back to Olodumare's palace. They said, "Olodumare, we are here. You've asked us to come. It's now 16 days. Which one of us have you decided to make the Oba of all the Ifa?" Ofumeji was so sure that it was going to be him. After all, he's the eldest of them all, and he felt that age trumps all. In fact, that was how they've always behaved. And because Ijogbe is so young to all of them, Ijogbe usually sat way at the back of the crowd. So Olodumare told them to wait, that he was going to come back. And because Ijogbe was at the back, they didn't even realize that Ijogbe had been taken away from behind them. Olodumare and Olodumare's emissaries took Ijogbe to a wing of Olodumare's palace. They adorned Ijogbe in expensive clothing, in expensive beads, and they placed a big, fanciful crown on his head. And Olodumare then called all the remaining brothers, say, "Okay, your Oba, your monarch is ready. Come and say kabiyesi to your Oba." Ah, they looked around, they were dumbfounded. They were thinking to themselves, "We thought this monarch was going to be one of us. It's not even one of us." And when they got to the room where Ijogbe was sat on his throne, Olodumare told them, "Prostrate, say kabiyesi to your monarch, to your Oba." And as they were approaching, Ofumeji kind of realized that, this is Ijogbe, this young boy. Ofumeji was a little bit hesitant. And Olodumare told him, "No, you are the one who came here to ask me to proclaim one of you the monarch. That is your monarch. Everyone say kabiyesi to your monarch." That was how Ijogbe became the monarch of all the Ifa. And before they went, Olodumare sent 200 emissaries from Orun to go and live with Ijogbe. And they went with all sorts of riches, all sorts of wealth, all sorts of expensive trinkets, which was used to establish Ijogbe's commanding presence as the monarch of all the Ifa. And that is how Ijogbe became the monarch or Oba of all the Ifa. The chant for this poem goes as follows. Okanjua ini o je ki won mo pin eni apa ba to si ini won mo fun ni tan eni gegesi aya ba to si ini won mo fun ni ku mo okun adifa fun odu bendi logun ijo ti won rele Olodumare ti won la won ololori ti won fe joba ninu ara won nje jiji laji o ila boba wa o jiji laji o ila boba wa ajibo wa ba ila beji ogbe jiji laji o la boba wa jiji laji o ila boba wa o jiji laji o ila boba wa ajibo wa ba ila beji ogbe jiji laji o la boba wa jiji laji o la boba wa o jiji laji o la boba Jibo waba ila beji ube. Gigi la Gio, la Boba.